Hi guys, welcome to Electrical Project Channel. And today in my laboratory I'm going to build a security alarm device with a reset button. This device is relatively simple and doesn't require any expensive components. Well, for building such alarm device we'll need 4 transistors BC547B, 6 10 kΩ resistors and 2 1 kΩ resistors. And also we'll need a small button for reset and an active 12V buzzer. And for triggering this alarm, I will use a reed switch and a magnet. Also, we'll need wires. Now we're ready to start soldering, but first let's look at the schematic. And at first, for some of you it may seem complicated, but actually it's not, especially when you understand what each part of the circuit does. In the center you can see a regular flip-flop circuit. This part of the circuit has some memory. And maybe word memory is too strong in our case, because it only remembers one bit of the information, 1 or 0. In our case it will only remember whether the alarm was triggered or not. And I'll show you how it works later in this video. On the right side you can see transistor Q4. It controls the active buzzer and works like a buffer between flip-flop circuit and a load. Transistor Q1 on the left part will trigger the flip-flop circuit. I'll explain why we need it a little bit later. To make soldering and troubleshooting a little easier, at first I'm going to build only a part of this circuit and test it. And then we'll go further. I will not use any PCB board, so it will be easier for you to see how everything connected. Well, first I'm going to connect and solder a black wire to emitter leads of transistor Q2 and Q3. Then let's connect two 10 kΩ resistors according to the circuit. So each resistor should be connected from collector lead of the first transistor to the base lead of the second transistor. And now let's solder 1 kΩ resistors to collector leads of the transistor Q2 and Q3. Also, let's solder 10 kΩ resistor between the collector lead of the transistor Q3 and the base lead of the transistor Q4. Emitter lead of the transistor Q4 should be connected to the negative wire. Let's solder everything. And now we can solder the buzzer. Let's solder the minus lead of the buzzer to the collector lead of the transistor Q4. And this part of the circuit is almost ready. Now let's solder the red wire to the plus lead of the buzzer and to the 1 kΩ resistors. And before we go any further, let's test this part of the circuit. For testing, we need to connect this circuit to a power source. I will use a 12V battery. But it is not all. In order to test this device, I'll connect a 10 kΩ resistor to this yellow wire and connect this wire to the plus lead of the battery. Now let's test it. Now when I touch the base lead of the transistor Q2, it activates the buzzer. And when I touch the base lead of the transistor Q3, it turns the buzzer off. As you can see, everything works fine, which means that we have soldered everything correctly. Now let's solder the button to the wires. After that, let's solder the first wire to the base lead of the transistor Q3. And let's solder the second wire to the 10 kΩ resistor. After that, 10 kΩ resistor should be soldered to the positive red wire. And now you can test this circuit again with a wire and 10 kΩ resistor, but it's not necessary. As you can see, you can already trigger this alarm and reset it with a button. And you may wonder why we need one more transistor. And it's all because of how read switch works. Let me show you. As you can see, without the magnet, the read switch doesn't conduct any electricity. And only starts to conduct electricity when I bring the magnet to it. And if I just install this switch with a magnet on a door, it will trigger the alarm when I close the door and not when I open it. Which is not what I need, and that is why we need one more transistor. So let's solder it, and I'll show you how it works with one more additional transistor. Let's solder the emitter lead of the transistor Q1 to the base lead of the transistor Q2. Then let's solder 10 kΩ resistor between the collector lead of the transistor Q1 and the positive wire. And let's connect one more 10 kΩ resistor, but this time between the base lead of the transistor Q1 and the positive wire. Now let's connect two wires that will go from this device to the read switch. Let's solder the first wire to the base lead of the transistor Q1. And let's solder the second wire to the minus. And this device is ready. Let's test it again. Now if I disconnect these wires, it will trigger the alarm. And even if I connect these wires together again, it will not turn the buzzer off. You need to reset the alarm with this button. And let's see how it works in real life. I've installed the read switch on this door and connected to our device. Let's see how it works. Everything works. And that is all for today. I hope this video was interesting. Thanks for watching and see you next time.